on YouTube. It's your boy ObiePress12 back with another gameplay commentary for you. And today I'm bringing you another Battlefield 4 Assault Weapons Guide. This is part 2. And the weapon of choice today is the second weapon that is unlocked or is unlocked automatically. And the gun is the SCAR-H. So I'm going to give you a little bit of some information, some statistics or stats and attachments that I'm using, along with a screenshot with the stats of the gun and what attachments I'm using with the gun in this particular gameplay. It's almost similar to the AK-12. And let's just jump right into it. So, SCAR-H is a weapon featured in Battlefield 2. It is a standard weapon that the Navy SEAL use. It is very similar to the SCAR-L. It has the same fire rate, but has a higher damage and lower recoil. The damage rate of the SCAR-H is 30 to 20. Depending if you have the gun suppressed or not. If it's suppressed, the suppressor reduces the damage rate of the gun by 10%. It is unlocked for an engineer with the engineer points at 14,000. The ammunition capacity of this gun is 20 plus 1 in the barrel. The reload time of the gun, which is the SCAR-H, is 2.1 seconds to 2.75 seconds. 2.1 is when the gun is half full, and 2.75 is when the clip is empty. The firing rate is 600 RPMs. The velocity of the gun is 420. The maximum range on the SCAR-H is 630 meters. The SCAR-H is a fully automatic and semi-automatic gun. The SCAR-H has 18 unlockables, 18 unlocks, based on the kills, the total kills in the game, or the total kills within the game, and also the battle packs that's unlocked within the game. So like I said, basically, that's all the information. You just seen a screenshot of what the default rate of the gun or the default stats of the gun a few minutes ago. Like I said, I'm using it in domination. The attachments that I have on this, on the SCAR-H right now, is the ACOG sights, the number 2 suppressor, the very last suppressor that's in the list of unlocks, and the long hand grip. That's what I'm using with this SCAR-H. Right now, like I said, I'm playing domination in this gameplay. And you see the recoil on this gun is very, very low because of the attachments that I have with the suppressor and the handle. As you see just now, hardly any recoil. Long distances, this gun is very good in close quarters. Very, very good in close quarters. If you like to hip fire a lot, I suggest add in the laser sight, the laser sight on it. But 9 times out of 10, this gun is pretty accurate. You don't even have to really use, you really don't have to use the laser sight on this gun. You can use a different perk. Throughout this whole game, I might have had a hip fire once and twice, and I do not have the laser sight on it. I do not have the laser sight on this gun. I have a red dot sight, but not a laser sight on the ACOG scope. I also will use a combo, like the combo light and laser, but that's like in team deathmatch, pretty much. At first, I had a hard time adjusting to this gun without the perks in the beginning or without the attachments in the beginning, because the gun has, in the beginning, when you first use it, it has a very, not high, but it has a punch. The very first bullet that you shoot, it has a very high recoil, the very first one. But after you either burst fire or go fully automatic, the gun will eventually even the recoil out. So therefore, it won't be that hard or that difficult to use. It didn't take me long to level the gun up in terms of opening up all the attachments for the gun. I pretty much have all the attachments for this gun open. I wanted to put this video out when I had them all completely open. But what I did was I forgot to open my battle packs in the end. And I'm going to show you a little bit of the battle packs at the very end of this gameplay as this time runs down. I'm going to show you the unlocks that comes within the battle packs. Like I said, I pretty much worked out all the kinks with this gun in terms of the recoil, so I can use this gun in any game mode. Right now, I mostly use it in TDM and domination, because they're close quarter games, and those are the type of games I like to play. In Conquest, I would change up the perks, or I would change up the attachments, and instead of using a suppressor on the gun, I'll probably use a long barrel, and instead of using the medium range scopes, I will probably go to long range scopes, which the time tools. As you can see, I'm about to hit fire right now, and without the laser, the gun is pretty good. It has a high hit fire rate. It has a high damage rate. It's like the highest in the assault rifles that I've seen so far. The damage rate on this gun is the highest. The accuracy on this gun is the highest when it comes to the assault rifles, without any attachments. Alright. Anyway, I'm gonna do a little cutscene, a little fast forward, and bring this game to a close so I can show you the battle packs. Stay tuned, keep it locked, I'll be right back. Alright, so as you can see, we won the game, and I just want to show you the battle packs right now that was achieved within that gameplay. So here we go, I'm going to show you all the battle packs. I'm still working on my medic. And look at the battle packs that's going to come up right now. All the ribbons and points. And here, at the end of the game, show you all the battle packs. These I forgot to open them before to have them in the game menu, so I'm showing you right now. These are all the parts that are needed or that are acquired after acquiring the kills in the game. I want to thank you for stopping by. This is your boy ObiPrez12 from Too Much Clues saying keep it locked, have a good one, and look out for my next video when I talk about the next assault rifle in the lineup. It's your boy ObiPrez12 from Too Much Clues, and I'm out. Have a good one. Peace.